Welcome to the Women in Business radio show with Sian Murphy, connecting women in business around the globe.
Hello and welcome back into the women. We still got the giggles. Look, I've been sat here with the headphones on, trying to distance myself. No, it didn't work. Still got the giggles. So welcome back into the Women in Business radio show studio. So we are now into the second hour of the show, and I must find a way of connecting the two together, mustn't I? Yeah. Don't start trying to pretend that it's actually happening on a different day. It's not. No, we're now a two.
We've got a structure now. We do have a structure.
We're now in part two. There is only one problem. Mm-hmm. There is, and I haven't introduced anybody yet, but there is only one problem with having this two-hour show. Mm-hmm. I need a wee. And it's downstairs. And I don't honestly think I can go clip-clopping.
I'm going to show my age now. We need a 12-inch track, you know, when they were slightly longer than the 45.
We do.
We've got to remember I'm not going to bring the age thing, but I know.
But I think of it like this, you know. Hey, I'm not weighing myself.
That's true.
Anybody listening in from any of the other DJs, generator, don't you worry about this, that I've sat in the DJ chair.
It's all good.
I'm sat here with, I don't know, potentially dodgy pelvic floor muscles. Who knows? Three cups of coffee before I got down here. It's all good. It's fine. It's a leather chair. We'll just wipe it down. I tell you what, it's not going to happen. It hasn't happened yet. It's not going to happen now. So, who have we got in the studio today? So, I'm Sian Murphy. I'm the host of the show. I don't quite know what I do. I just arrive here and talk. My co-host is Adelle Martin. Welcome, Adelle.
Hi.
And our guest in the studio today is Fiona Shoults, who is the founder of Microblading and More.
Hello.
So we have a different focus for this show. We are talking about how, as women in business, we can look good and feel good. So this is how it's going to be from now on. The first half of the show is going to go from 11 until 12. We are going to talk about starting and growing your business. We're going to be talking about numbers. We're going to be talking about getting out there, strategy, planning, writing stuff down, doing stuff, social media, all of the do and plan that you need to do to make your business grow. But it's not just about that, is it? Because we also have us. We're people, I think. We have feelings. We need stuff. We need to look good and feel good about what we do. And so the second half of the show from now on is going to be about that. If you are listening on something like Audible, if you're listening to the podcast, we take this chaos and, well, we don't do anything with it at all, actually. You see, a really well-produced show, this is what they do. They edit out all the mad bits, all the falling off the chair, all the needing to go to the loo, and you'd end up with something slick and you know, sort of, well, slick.
Yeah.
We don't do that.
No, don't.
We don't do that. It is as it is. You get, it's like WYSIWYG. What you see is what you get, yeah. And it goes out, and it goes in two halves out on Audible. You can catch us on
Spotify, Audible, Alexa, as long as you've enabled the skill, and then podcasts and Spreaker.
Yes. Google Podcasts. Yeah. In fact, we're on Heart. Only I have no idea how to find the show on there. I know that it exists because I can see people listening to it through there, but I have no idea. I can't find it myself. So I would forget all about that. And the other thing that we're now doing, we are starting up a members newsletter, so you can become a member of the Women in Business radio show for a very small fee. It's £7 a month. It helps us to keep going and helps us to get information out to you so that you can connect. You're contributing to us as a show. You're also contributing to the women that we have on here, the business women, which could be you. Which could be you. Never think that this isn't right for you. Anybody can come onto a radio show. Certainly anybody can come onto our radio show. We love having people. Yeah. You just have to be ready to share.
Yep.
That's all you have to be willing to share.
And some fun.
Yeah, don't take anything too seriously, for goodness sake. Won't go down at all well here. So, what else do we need to say? You can connect with us on Twitter. We are on WIB Radio Live. We are on Instagram, the Women in Business Radio Show. And we are on Facebook and LinkedIn as the Women in Business Radio Show. At some point, I'm going to sort all of that lot out.
Yeah.
And try and get them together. But it's all a bit too late now. It's all like now it's major admin. So, I'll find another way of doing that. So, we have some announcements about events. So, this, down in Kent, which is where I am, We have Cafe in the Calm is running the Psychic Health and Beauty Fairs at Maidstone Snowfields Academy on Saturday. That's between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. And there's healing, there's massage, there's reflexology, there's Indian head massage, there's all crystal healing. What have I forgotten? We have crystals there. We have all sorts. There's lots going on. We also have psychic mediums, psychic readers. So there's really a lot for you to do. There's also a cafe. You can sit down. You can spend the day. You can journal. We have spiritual books. We have normal books, whatever they are. You can just sit down and really just sort of chill out and have a good day. And we are, again, the next day, we are at Longfield Academy. Yes. We are at Longfield Academy on the Sunday, so you can come along and do exactly the same thing again. Yes. So we would love to see you. Head to both of those venues, and there's loads of free parking. So that's what we do. It's a good space for your head, and it's a good space to get your bits of your body sorted out as well. And that's actually what we're going to be talking about. So in a moment, I'm just rattling my paper around. Doesn't that sound, if you're listening in, you can, doesn't that sound professional? It sounds like I've got a plan. Okay, I'm just going to put those down because that's just upsetting everybody. So now I'm looking at this. There's nothing on here. There's nothing on it. Okay, we are going to have.
There's more papers there.
Yeah, I've got more. That's from the other show. Okay, so we have a little bit of a different format. What we've done is sort of split everything out and mashed it together all at the same time. So what we're going to be having in the second half of the show, when we're looking at Look Good, Feel Good, we're going to talk about what we've learned this week. We're going to talk about books that we're reading, and we're going to talk about quotes that have helped us. And despite coming up with this, I'm really hoping that somebody else has got something, because I don't. So I can't go with Eckhart Tolle again.
Exactly. Well, do you know what? Yes, you can, and I'll tell you why in a minute.
All right. Okay. What have you learnt this week?
What have I learnt this week is gut instinct. Yeah. I think probably I have not focused and listened to my gut instinct enough. And I'm going to trust my gut more. My gut instinct.
Trust your gut instinct.
Yeah. Yeah.
How are you going to do that, though? Because sometimes, say you think your gut is telling you not to do something.
Yeah.
How do you know that it's telling you that because it's right, or because you're just scared, or you're trying to get out of doing something because of lack of confidence or procrastination or self-sabotage?
Yeah. I think for me, I call it three-strike rule. So something is trying to tell me something, and I've ignored it. No, I'm not going to do that. No, that's not right. And then it's come back to me a second time. So, I'm still thinking this through. Yeah, and then third time, I'm going to do it. But you're right, sometimes procrastination or just, no, I'm not going to do it. So for me, if I come across it three times, I'm going to listen to my gut. And I made some conscious decisions not to do that, and they were the wrong ones. So I think it's just that decision in how many more people do you talk to or signs actually that's the right thing to do. So it's not just, that's my gut instinct, I'm going to go in this direction.
Yeah.
It's just I've seen a couple of things or been told a couple of things that I may have chose to ignore, and actually my gut feeling's right.
I think sometimes we choose to ignore them because they're actually much harder to do, aren't they? It could be, there's this big thing that you know, you've got to have a horrible conversation that you don't want to have. You might have to take big action about where you're living or where your business is going and all of that sort of thing. And so I think partly we kid ourselves, oh no, that's okay, that's not really the right thing to do, when actually it is the right thing to do.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. So that's just me.
Listen to your gut. What have you learnt this week, Fiona?
Ooh, what have I learnt? I think talk to the universe, put stuff out there. I've always thought it was a bit woo-woo, but I'm testing it more and more, and it's really coming in, it's really working, and listening. So, and not fretting about stuff, because if you worry about something happening, you kind of make it happen, and you don't want it to happen. So I've stopped doing that, and I'm letting things come to me. I'm putting stuff out there. Sorry if that's a bit woo-woo.
You've set your intention, isn't it? Yeah, you've set your intention, and then rather than just... I think it's force versus flow. Sometimes, and I've been in so much danger of just trying to force things through. Yeah. I do think it's still coming out from corporate and where I've been. I'm trying to force things through and actually just slow and flow it down.
Yeah.
And actually, I'm more calm, and actually things are coming to me. Yeah. I have a tendency to want to force things through.
Maybe that's where mine comes from, from corporate as well, then. It could be, couldn't it? Yeah. Trying to push things all the time.
Mm.
yeah, as I'm relaxing into my business.
It is, because very often there's a pressure that isn't you, is there? There's a, you know, when we come from corporate, there's this has to be done and it has to be done by then, and somebody else is looking over our shoulder to make sure that it is. Mm. And actually, if you don't ever make a decision to get something done, nothing will ever happen. Mm. But there are certain things you can actually just let evolve.
Yeah.
Organically.
Mm. Yeah, it does work better.
Yeah,
I've been concentrating on stuff the last few weeks. I'm thinking, I don't know why I'm doing that. Someone's told me I should do it, so I'm doing it. But it's taking up time, and I don't even think I'm going to use what I'm doing. Mm. So, yeah, it's time to regroup on that one.
Yeah. I think my one, what I've learnt this week, is to really practice acceptance. And just accept a situation, because I can't change it. Mm. It's out of my control. So there's no point in fighting it.
Yeah.
Mm. There is literally no point in fighting it. That doesn't mean I have to like it, but that is where it is, and just accept, okay, that's it. I can't make that change.
Yeah. Save your energy.
Yeah. I mean, my particular situation that I have at the moment is that I have three animals that are all 20 and creaking around. And, you know, animals, they get older, a bit like us, really, they smell. But they do, don't they? They, you know, fur starts dropping off. You know, they're starting to get older, and it has been driving me absolutely nuts having these three creaky, smelly animals. I'd love them to bits. They ain't going anywhere. And I've been fighting it. I've been resisting it and getting, oh goodness me. And now I've just, actually, that is the situation.
Yep. Yep.
Just accept it.
Yep.
And that's it. And life is, once I stopped fighting it and huffing and puffing about it, life, it just, oh, okay, that is just how it is.
A lot calmer now.
Yeah, it is. I can't, you know, that's it, I've accepted it. So, accept what you can't change.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah.
And I've heard that so many times before, and I think we hear it quite a lot. Control what you can control and let go what you can't. But it's one thing hearing it and actually do an identifying a situation
in your own life
mm. and doing it.
Yeah. I agree. Especially if it's making you uncomfortable as well. It's really hard.
Yeah.
If you're apologising all the time for them and
yeah. It's you just have to identify that thing.
Mm. And sit with it. It's something you just have to sit, you can't just sit with it. Yeah. And yeah, I agree.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Okay, so books. What books are we on? They can be story books, they can be audio books, they can be anything books. Fire away.
I'm reading Jacqueline Gold's autobiography at the moment. I stumbled across a podcast with her on. You know Jacqueline Gold, Anne Summers lady?
Oh, yeah. Well, she came up the other week, didn't she?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
She's amazing. And so I'm reading her book, and yeah, she's a great inspiration, very motivational lady.
What is it? Is there anything in particular that sort of springs out for you?
She just stood up for herself and her business, and she had the idea, and she was told many times it wasn't going to work, but you know, look at her now, it did.
Yeah, off she goes.
She's very fair in business, and I worked for Anne Summers a while back, but only for a short period of time.
We had another guest on last week as well.
Didn't we? And was it?
It was
I can't remember. Mind
shop. Lady.
Oh, yes. Sylvia Otway, the body shop queen.
Yes,
also worked with Anne Summers.
For a long time, yeah.
Have you got a book, Adelle?
So you can have Eckhart, because I've got to say this.
I can't have Eckhart again.
No, I'll tell you why. Okay, I'm going to say this once more, and I promise I won't bring him into this conversation again. Right, there is an amazing podcast I was listening to yesterday, and I just needed it. Somebody sent it to me, and it's an interview with Bear Grylls, but it's by Stephen Bartlett.
Not him again.
That's the last one.
For goodness sake.
I'm listening to it at the moment.
It's three of us in this relationship. I'm so sorry, Sean. But I'm honestly, he's relegated. No, because, you know, sometimes somebody...
Some hot podcaster. Honestly, I'll tell you what, it doesn't take much, does it?
I hadn't noticed.
Does a bit of trouser. Oh, you hadn't noticed. I hadn't noticed.
No. And it's, but for me, he's bringing her out resilience.
Yeah.
Okay. And he was talking about the resilience of keep going and getting up, and also when to quit, which is a bit similar to what you said, when to sit with it. And he, and that's what he was talking about. And I'm listening to a second time because I'm thinking, God, I get that. It's resonating. And it's knowing when to quit and walk away because it's not worth the fight.
Yeah.
And sometimes he says people just get so caught up with winning and then they end up losing. And I thought, oh, that's so good. And he was talking about, but you have that conversation when no one's looking. You know, what can you do? What can you really do when no one's looking? Because we can all be good on a good day, but can you be good on a bad day? And I like the way that Love or Hate Bear Grylls and what he does. What he brought out was knowing when to walk away and when to quit. And I like that. I thought it was good.
We ought to have a show on that because it's critical, isn't it? Yeah. Because I think we get so caught up sometimes in business about, oh, no, well, it's not failure. It's only you've just found out something. So keep going, you know, keep at it. Same thing. Mm-hmm. You know, we just sort of keep pedaling. We keep pedaling along. And there are times when it just isn't working. It's not work. It's never going to work.
And that's what he said. Resilience is keep going and keep carrying and go, no. Resilience is also knowing when to stop. Yeah. It's not about keep going. And I'm like, yeah, I get that.
Because if you keep going, sorry, we're going to deteriorate right now into this, like, this conversation. If you just keep going, I'm not going to give up. I'm going to keep going. That's actually ego.
Yes, that's what he said.
See, and you don't mean that. Like, you don't mean I said something as wonderful as the fantastic Nicker Waggling Stephen Bartlett.
Oh, that was his name.
Yeah, it's ego. Ego gets in the way.
It is, isn't it? I'm not going to give up. Mm. I'm a winner.
Mm.
You need to fail a little bit before you win, though, don't you?
Yeah,
to be fair.
Yeah,
but you can. I think there's a difference between failing and giving up what you're doing, and failing and finding a different way to do something, and just mindlessly keeping going. Okay, I think that's critical, and I don't think we've got a solution here. I mean, apart from listening to Stephen Bartlett's podcast, obviously. Right. So going over to a much better, going and finding a much better program.
So I will not bring him. I will divorce him from this relationship. But that one was a good podcast because again, see, we talk about resilience a lot. Well, I do. Obviously, it's what my foundation is. My club.
I don't have, I haven't got a book. I'm
that's why I said to him, because I knew what I was going to say.
No, I can't mention Eckhart Tolle again. Although the acceptance thing is actually from Eckhart Tolle, and also actually following on, I suppose, from that again is actually recognizing when my own ego is kicking in.
Yes.
Because ego, you know, I think very often as women, we use it as almost dirty term for men, don't we? Oh, he's got a massive ego. Well, we've all got an ego.
Exactly, women are.
We all have an ego. Yeah. And I have become aware of when my ego, when my ego is kicking in and how to sort of bring it. How to bring it back down again because it isn't about me. I don't know if that's strange. You know? Shocker, eh?
My ego is called Annabelle. So when Annabelle comes up, then I know that I need to deal with it because Annabelle. Mm. And we all that. But also, it's also kind of an ego. I'm pushing it away. I just give Annabelle just 2 minutes and then she's gone. Because otherwise, you just suppress it.
I'm not at all worried, okay, that my co-host talks about facets of her whatever in the third person. There's more than one of them as well. I'm sure it's absolutely fine.
I am fine, honestly. She's gone. She's outside today.
Okay. Oh. So no ego.
No, she's on the naughty step.
Right. Okay. I've forgotten where we were now.
Quote.
Yeah, it is actually sort of taking your own ego out of what you're doing in your business is critical because all the time you're focused on your own ego, you're not actually looking at what everybody else wants and needs. And if you're not doing that, then you aren't going to succeed.
Exactly.
And being prepared to be, I'll say wrong, but being prepared to be wrong.
Just have conversation. Yeah. It's just challenging conversation. You can't do that when your ego is.
But you do have to be aware of it. You have to be able to look at. Yeah, you have to be able to look at it. Well, that was a load of a waffle, wasn't it? So now what? We're on to quotes. I haven't got one. I haven't got one. You haven't got one either. Do you know why that is? That's because you didn't fill the form in.
If you, I didn't have a form.
You did have a form. If you'd have opened your emails, you would have found it.
I've got one.
Oh, no, you would have, wouldn't you? And did,
is it
from Trouser Rocking Stephen Bartlett? Has he said something absolutely fantastic this week?
No, he hasn't.
I'm just looking on Instagram.
You've got the quote hashtag. Do you know what mine is?
Go on.
This has been the start of the week. Surround yourself with people that are going to take you higher, and that's why I'm free. Right, I'm out of here.
Ooh.
No, I think that's really important. I think, again, I come back to what Fiona said in part one of the show, like in this language, is it can be lonely, and whoever you're surrounded by, if they don't want you to grow, no matter how good you are, you won't grow. Yeah. So surround yourself with people that are going to take you higher. And I do think that you're the sum of the people around you. And I think for me, probably over the last year, coming back to like who I network with, I think that's been quite a key thing for me. And I just love, and to be honest, that quote come up from Oprah. And I thought, damn good she's right.
And I use my own quote that I base my business around. Go. It's not vanity, it's normality.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, I like that. Look, hang on. We've got somebody who's invented their own quote.
It's not my ego here.
No, it's fine.
Out with Annabelle.
I'm going to not challenge you, but I sort of am going to challenge you on that, actually. Mm-hmm. And in fact, I'm just about to something I'm writing this week. It's not going to be that startling. I mean, we're talking about an Instagram post. Is about dealing with people who crush your butterfly.
Yeah. Mm.
And you know those people who, there are some people who you say, oh, I'm going to do this, that, and the other, and they actually will almost find a way to squash that. And they, I think what we call, they crush your butterfly. They make it look smaller than it is. They belittle you. I'm going to say sometimes they haven't actually done that on purpose, but by not going, oh, wow, lovely, that's super. Oh, you're so clever. Oh, I think that's brilliant. Because you didn't get that validation, you're actually knocked back a bit. So that's the first thing, is that they may not have done it deliberately, that you just may not have got the validation that you're expecting. Mm. And the second thing is that sometimes these people highlight where we are deluding ourselves about what we are doing and why we are doing it. And so sometimes you actually need to spend time with them to get a different perspective on what you're actually up to. And that if somebody says something to you and you sort of shrink a bit, you think, instead of going, I need to run away from this person because, you know, they're not supporting me, to actually take a step back and go, okay, what have they just said or done that has made me doubt myself?
And that, again, it's having that trusting network.
Yeah, I'm not saying you want to be around somebody who's a complete git. No. But if they are actually genuinely doing that all the time and they're really horrible, they've just got to go, haven't they? Out the door, bye.
If it's somebody you trust and you say, can I have your opinion on that, then for me that's that trusted network. Rather than someone who's deliberately going to crush you on purpose, versus you've got someone in your team and you know they can give, just tell me the truth.
It's constructive.
Constructive is the intent. It's the intent of the information.
Yes. Yeah. But just be aware that it might not all be them, and sometimes we need these miserable buggers to actually point out that everything may not be as fantastic and rosy as I am kidding myself it is. And sometimes people don't see what it is that I'm doing. I see what it is, and I know what it is in my head, but perhaps I haven't explained it properly. So that was just a thought.
No, I like that.
I don't have a quote. What I do have, however, is, and I'm sorry if I'm going to bring this the things down, I am going to just mention what has happened in the States with that ruling over the overturning of Roe versus Wade. It doesn't affect me personally, but I think it affects all of us as women.
Yes, it does.
And I've got here the and it affects other people as well. It's not just women, it affects everybody. It's a taking away of choice.
That could be the start of other things.
Yes, it is the taking away of choice. And I have a letter here that was written by Michelle Obama. You know, here we are, we're sat in the UK. What can we do? in theory, nothing. But she has published this, and she's got a couple of places that she has suggested. This was written for women in the States, but I think we can go and connect with them, and that we can start, we can have a conversation and go, what can we do? You know, we have a voice here. Yeah,
we do.
We have a voice, and we can connect with other women and have a voice from outside the States. So here are the two resources. I'm going to share them here. So the first one is Planned Parenthood. And that's the website as well. It's plannedparenthood.org. And the other one is the United States of Women Reproductive Justice Hub. And that is so great if I could see. It would be... that is usow.org/repro/. So we're sat here in the UK.
Share that out on our Instagram. Yeah, on our Women in Business.
Yeah, region. Yes. I mean, you know, here we are. We are in the UK, but we're broadcasting internationally, and as women collectively, as a community with influence, we need to. Every little person needs to tap in and see what is it that I can do. Even if you just send a pound, there must be something that we can do to start making a little bit of noise about this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it's not on.
No, it's not.
Right, that's my bit. I've said that.
No.
And if I could get hold of them, I would see. I haven't had time this week to see if they would like to come onto the show. Mm. Bearing in mind, it's a really dodgy time for them over there. They have to get up at silly o'clock. Mm-hmm. So that's it. Reach out. What can we do? Mm. Right then, should we get on to something a little bit more fun? What are we going to talk about? So, look good, feel good. We have got in the studio with us the lovely Fiona Shoults, who microblading and more. Who, that's what you do, isn't it? You spend your time helping mainly women to look good and feel good about themselves.
Absolutely.
What was that quote you just... Can you set that quote again?
It's not vanity, it's normality.
In what context would that specifically be? Are we talking about me putting my mascara on in the morning, or are we talking about actually perhaps having something done that is a little bit more permanent?
It could even go back down as far as you putting your makeup on, because it takes a little bit of time, and I think as we get older we start feeling a bit guilty spending time on ourselves. That's where it came from, really. I know I had semi-permanent makeup done 17 years ago, and people said, how much did that cost? Oh, that's a bit vain, isn't it? And I was like, no, actually, it's not. And that's the foundation of my business, is helping people feel better and talking them through it as well. Not pushing them into it, but if they want to have it done and they feel guilty, I give them positive thoughts around it as well, so they can feel better about spending that money.
I think as business women, I see two sides of it. Sometimes I see women who have very high profiles, who are then going out there and taking all of their makeup off and saying, I don't need to wear, you know, I'm going to just be au naturel and this is how I am. And there's a bit of me that goes, yeah, good for you. But there's another bit of me that goes, actually, perhaps I want to wear makeup. What's wrong with wearing makeup? I quite like wearing makeup. It makes me feel better. How bad is that, really a problem?
Yeah. No.
If it makes me feel better and it's not for anybody else, that's okay.
Yeah, absolutely. But it's people that want something done and then feel guilty about A, spending the money, B, taking the time. I had a lady come yesterday for her first treatment, and she was really nervous, and she was only having a facial treatment. And she said, I don't really ever spend time on myself or spend any money. She booked her next 7 months treatment scene and she was there. Because she said, I won't do it unless I do it now. I won't do it, because she felt guilty. But she went and she sent me a message last night, said, I feel great, I'm glad it's all booked in. She's gone off on a holiday, she feels amazing.
Yeah.
So.
Agree. And I think, again, there's that shift between, we've gone from anti-aging, you know, 10 years ago, now it's now pro-aging. And do you know what? I want to age and do what I want to do.
Yeah,
and not feel like, oh, you've had this done or had that done. I want to do that. If I've earned the money from running my own business and I want to reinvest some in my tech and some on me, and do you know what? It's come back to choices. It's my choice that I'm going to do that. And that's not vain. It's just wanting to feel normal. Because, again, the type of women I work with, you know, our bodies do change. And our hair and our skin and our nails change. And if I want to have some permanent makeup put on, because through menopause my body is changing, then I want to do that, and I don't want to be judged for it. And that's when Fiona and I first met, and I said, I love that title, because that encapsulates what I'm fighting against. It's not vanity. I just want to feel okay and normal, and not be judged for it.
But I think you will be judged.
Yeah.
I think we are judged.
Yeah.
And that will always happen, because there are just people like that. We're going to be judged for everything. I think it's a case of actually not caring.
Caring.
How does this affect you? If I have my nails done, how does this, you know, as long as, all right, it's going to make it easier for me to scratch your eyes out. But how does it affect you? And I'm sure some clever ass will come up with something. Oh, well, it's affecting the planet, or it's doing something or other. But in actual fact, how is it really affecting you?
Yeah.
If I have my nails
it's
done,
not, is it? It's about self care and how you feel.
Self care. Yeah,
you've
absolutely.
Got to look after your own mental health. Mm. And if having a facial gives you half an hour a month, that's not a lot, is it?
Mm.
Can't come more often.
And there's two aspects to it, isn't there? There's the actual physical result,
yeah.
But there's also the time that you spend. So I have a massage. I regularly have a full body sort of pummeling massage, and I know that it has a huge effect on my back and keeping me mobile, but it also has a huge effect on my head as well. And to me, a lot of what I have done, and I think this is a superb reason for being in business, is all business expenses.
Yeah, exactly.
It is. You know, me being able to stand upright, so having a massage, business expense.
Absolutely.
Me looking okay and looking clean, so having a facial, is also part of my brand.
Yeah.
Having my nails done is actually just quite practical. It means that, you know, it's a bit of a pain in the bum going down to the salon, but for 1 hour a month, I haven't got to worry. I don't have to get up in the morning and go, oh, I'm out. Oh, look at my nails. Yeah. I've got, you know, putting nail varnish on as you're going down the road. I don't have to do any of that. And my nails are always, always clean and tidy.
Absolutely. And again, I have, the same as you, a plan. But it comes back to, and I know you talk about this all the time, women like, oh, I'll have a massage when I'm broken, or a facial when my skin's bad. Mm. It's vitamin versus pill. So the way I look at my self-care plan, I am with Fiona every other week, have my nails done every three. Da-da. It's all in the diary, because if I don't, I haven't got to think about it. And like you, I have to rock up present. I don't want to go, oh, Adelle, can you be on stage tomorrow? Oh, my God, I can't, because I got my... No, I am constantly ready, and it's the consistency. Otherwise, you end up having a panic, and also it's about... maintenance, where unfortunately people they own that vitamin versus pill. They wait until their skin's bad or they've got a bad back, and then they pay the money. And so for me, it's a maintenance plan.
So when we're looking at maintenance, Fiona,
yes,
you are the beauty expert. We just have stuff done.
Yeah, she does it. Yeah.
So in your experience, and we're not telling anybody what they should be doing here, we're just saying in your experience, and then there's also Adelle and I, who are the potential receivers of having stuff done, what are sort of the basic essentials to keep yourself looking good and feeling good?
I think as we age, our skin dries out and you just start getting the wrinkles. And if you're bothered by it, that's when you need to start doing something about it. But it's just consistency. You need to regularly look at your diet, because it's so important. Your skin shows what you're doing on the inside as well. And I've learned quite a lot, having been doing some of Adelle's face regularly, just watching. She looks after herself, and you can see what happens to someone's skin. It tells everything. So yeah, you need to look after yourself on the inside and be consistent with your product use.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. So, you know, picking products, some people have a big budget, some people have a small budget.
Yeah.
Is there something for everybody? Is there something that everybody can do to... for me, it's actually about keeping my face feeling okay. If I don't moisturise, I feel dry and uncomfortable.
It's horrible, isn't it?
I can feel it. It's not just about how I look, it actually just doesn't feel very nice. And I'm sort of not itching, but I'm conscious of it. So, you know, And I realise perhaps we don't want to be mentioning particular products, but is there really a solution for everybody? I personally like to have stuff that isn't full of crap.
Yeah, I was about to say that. Product, there is something at every price point, really.
Are there particular things that I'm sort of aware that, you know, you look at some of the really, really, really cheap stuff and that it may be have stuff in it that is like just making up the room.
I'm about to say that. It'll have the same products, like hyaluronic acid, the one I can never say. Yeah. So it'll have the same products and the same vitamins, but a tiny amount of them.
Yeah.
So they'll be in the ingredients, but they'll be carried in a packing ingredient.
Yeah.
So cheaper. When you use it, you need to use twice as much to get the same result.
Okay. Yeah. And are there any red flags as far as, what should we call it, the carrier stuff? You know, is there anything that you really shouldn't be putting on your face or in anywhere else? Is there something you can just say, don't, just stay away from that?
I know in my products for washing my hair and stuff, not just putting on my face, sodium lauryl sulfate. Yeah, because that's in most shampoos and most shower gels. And it dries your skin.
So stay away from the sulfates. Yeah. I think there's quite a lot of sulfate-free products around now, yes, aren't there?
Yeah, there are, absolutely.
What about things like coconut oil? I'm not saying you wouldn't necessarily wash your hair in coconut oil, would you? But what about things like coconut oil?
Fine. And it's finding something that's good for your skin. If you're putting oil back into your skin, then it's going to help it. But sometimes it will need the help, or it does need the help of the vitamin C and the hyaluronic acid.
Yeah.
But if you're going for if your skin's quite dry, if you put the coconut oil on at night, that's going to be quite good.
Mm.
And especially for holiday, it smells nice as well.
Yeah. Yeah. And to be honest, gosh, Fiona and I talk about this all the time. Yeah. People come to me and go, Adelle, there's this skin cream with the M word on it and it's worth all this money. Is this going to... And I say, Fiona, and we've got, you know, is it got hyaluronic acid? Because otherwise you end up in this false marketing around beauty.
Yeah.
And what I've said to Fiona, and I still say this every time, it blows me away of how many, there must be thousands and thousands of beauty brands, and you just get swamped with the marketing. And as we say, you know, if you don't have the right food and drink water, doesn't matter how expensive that face cream is, you're going to struggle. But we work on the basis of key ingredients and consistency rather than a £300 price tag. Yeah. Is not going to make it work. It really isn't.
So you do something every morning, every night. How much water, I don't know if you can answer this question, how much water can you should you actually be drinking a day, and can you count other liquids, not wine? not wine.
No. For me, when I talk to my clients, I ask them in about two litres, but in the summer when it's hot, I say closer to three. If you're with people who I'm having teas and coffees, then they will actually a diuretic, so they're actually going to take the water out. So I would say don't count your tea and coffee, because they're just going to dehydrate you. So between 2 to 3 litres a day, holding up my bottle, is what I do. But if it's very hot, but also, if, for instance, you are sweating a lot through sport or hot flushes or anything, do you know what you can tell by your skin? If your skin feels really tight and flat, then have extra water. When generally people will start to put lots of hand cream on, but for me, we say, well, Fiona, like, it's inside and outside, so you've got to drink the water and put the hand cream on as well.
Definitely plumps up the skin.
Yeah, and so, also fruits that are like avocados, olives. So having the coconut oil, having the oils on the inside as well as the outside, just always think both inside and outside.
So the busy businesswoman's maintenance program.
Bath in coconut oil and eat it.
Oh, look at that, look at a slogan.
Banana tip.
I'm sorry, we're not having a I don't think so. No.
That's another show.
Oh, yes, all together. Okay, all right, I've bitten it now, okay? I've bitten. What's the banana?
I do a little tip each week. And the
really?
One. Eat your banana, eat the skin, and on the inside, and rub it on any fine lines and wrinkles until it starts to oxidise and go brown.
Hang on a minute. Eat the skin.
No, eat the banana, and then keep the skin.
Keep it.
Rub it on your face,
yeah,
on any problem areas, until it goes a bit brown, and leave it on for a little while, then rinse it off, and it helps those fine lines and wrinkles.
Mm. Does it really?
Apparently so. Mm. I haven't tried it yet.
Oh. Well.
The other day, we were talking about using cucumbers to help with cellulite. Sorry.
And your face.
And your face.
Too much Stephen Bartlett for you.
Here comes the
nurse. Honestly, this is ridiculous. How old are we? And we're talking about phallic throat. Goodness
I
me.
Your skin.
You think we'd be past all of that, wouldn't you?
I've thrown this question to Fiona. Fiona, help me with my cellulite. She said cucumber. I was like, okay. And then she goes on to explain.
You've got cellulite? Where? You're like a pair of scissors. I can show you some cellulite.
Get some cucumber.
Cucumber.
Eat it or rub it?
Rub it.
Really?
Yeah. Rub it on your cellulite. Yeah. And it helps diminish it. I have no memory for names anymore, so I can't even tell you why, but I have to read it from my notes.
Okay, this is going to be an interesting afternoon, is it? How often do you need to do that?
Oh, I think regularly is quite good.
Okay, rub a cucumber.
If you're going out somewhere and you don't want it to show through an outfit, then do it before you go.
Is it really that fast?
Apparently so. Mm, it does. Have you tried it now?
Yeah, I have, yeah. Because obviously, putting into concept, I am competing in a bodybuilding competition on the 4th of November. So everything's going to be on show. So, I have got a small bikini to wear, but I've been...
Hey, folks. Okay, so what you're seeing, all right, what you're seeing is not Adelle's real body. You're seeing the cucumber rubbing results. But, yes, you wait. Once it's over, once she's over, in that dressing room, I yeah, it's like honestly,
and it has it, the skin again from the skin tone. Yeah, skin tone's very good actually.
Okay,
because I always think of cucumber on your
eyes. On your eyes. Yeah, okay,
put it on my legs.
Okay, so your face cream or your coconut oil. Drink lots of water. Get your banana out.
Absolutely.
Rub yourself with the cucumber.
Hyaluronic acid, isn't it?
Now you can get that separately, can't you? So you can. So instead of going out and spending huge amounts of money on a cream that has, I can't say it now, hyaluronic acid in it, you can actually buy it as a product, can't you? And you can.
There's a serum in it.
And you could put it in a carrier. You could put it in your coconut oil.
You could do. Yeah.
Can I name a shop?
Yeah.
So if you go to somewhere like TK Maxx that has high-end brands and others, if you go in there and go into the beauty section, you can find a lot of these products a lot cheaper than if you went into a main department store and buy these things. And yeah.
Can I nitpick?
Yes.
I think we can. I'm very good at nitpicking. I was just going to say, if we're talking about consistency and product consistency, then sometimes if you go into TK Maxx and you get something that either has been discontinued or that you may not be able to afford the next time.
Yeah, so if I do, I'll buy a couple of those.
So be prepared to maybe pay full price for it another time if you like it.
But it's good for try if you buy it. And if you have a product that really works, I dread to think over the year I've gone into high-end department stores, bought something, used it once. I had a drawer of used once things. Mm. At least with TK Maxx, you can have a play around with it.
Mm. What else we got then? Come on, regular. What should we be doing regularly?
Regularly, I would exfoliate at least once a week.
And how do you? How I know how I exfoliate. I don't want anybody thinking I don't exfoliate. For goodness sake. How would you go about exfoliating? Is there a product that perhaps you use, or have you got some other sort of fruit?
Banana's quite good for that.
okay. So the banana is an exfoliant.
It's good for your texture.
Okay.
Skin texture. But just any whatever brand you're using, exfoliant is good. The one I use is more of a chemical one, so you can only use it once a week. Do you use that at home as well?
Yeah, I use
that's pretty good.
But we can mention a brand. It's okay. I didn't. I was more concerned about mentioning a brand that we didn't like. So if there is something that you do like that you are recommending, then yes.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't say for someone to ditch what they've already got.
Yeah.
If you've got a exfoliator, then use it every week. Don't just leave it on the shelf. It lasts a long time, but doesn't help.
And what's the one that you...
I use Clinicare.
Clinicare.
Yeah. Which is, but you can't buy their innocent peel. You have to get it from someone that...
Oh, do you sell it?
That's someone that uses it. No, that's the way it's in. I can't sell it.
Why?
I can't sell that. Because it's so good, people get a bit addicted to it. Mm. So, but I can give little samples and...
Got you. So it's something that you use as part of... So you actually need to see somebody and have that done professionally.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay.
It is good.
So... exfoliation. What else do we need to be doing regularly?
Serums. You need your serum.
Serums. Yeah, what's a serum? Tell me what a serum is. You hear about it a lot, don't you? But what is it?
It seals in. If you're cleansing and you're toning, you're exfoliating, then you put your serum on and it prepares your face ready to put the moisturiser on top. Mm. It sort of locks everything in there and it helps you absorb the...
So it's different to... What's the difference between a serum and a toner?
Toner refreshes and closes the pores. And then the serum just holds it on reasonable, isn't it? The serum just holds it all in there.
Mm. Yeah, because I got told off because I wasn't toning properly, was I?
But have you noticed a difference?
Yeah, I have noticed a difference.
Yeah.
I have two types of toner. I have an exfoliating toner.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And I have a toner. I don't know what...
To be fair, I said I had a printer toner. My printer. She said to me, "Were you cleaning?"
I tell you what, I never used to do anything with my face at all. Literally nothing with my face. And then it started getting really quite dry and really quite uncomfortable. Mm. And now I do the whole thing, and it's sort of I've got it as a routine. So it's by the bath, and I do it in the bath.
Yeah, exactly. But also, again, what Fiona's also taught me, the face doesn't just stop here; it goes down to the neck.
It does,
and also
yes.
The back of your hands, as well. So sometimes if I'm doing exfoliation. I put it on the back of my hand as well, because between your neck and your hands is what's on show. So for me, I use those products. But did you put that on your hands? I said, they're on show as much as... And like you, if you're presenting and you're talking, then yeah, back of your hands as well. It's just as sensitive as your face. But yeah, Fiona goes...
I'm looking at them now.
Your face goes all the way down.
Okie dokie. Yeah, no, that's a really, really good... That's a really good tip. We've not got an awful lot of time left, so... What else do we need to be doing regularly if we are going to keep ourselves looking good and feeling good?
Just having a treatment regularly, just to get someone else to do your skin for you, because they can see it. And
you
spend a lot of money. And on your products, you were saying earlier, you don't need to buy high-end products. You just need to be consistent.
Yeah.
It's no point buying a lot of stuff and not using it.
Consistency, yeah. Definitely.
So when you get somebody, I suppose the benefit of getting somebody else to do stuff is, you just said, they're looking at your skin. Yeah. So it's perhaps a case of finding somebody that you enjoy working with and sort of sticking with them, if that's possible, because they get to see changes, they get to see what's happening with your skin.
And if you're using something at the moment that you've been using for years and you trust it, it might not be right for your skin. You might be thinking, yeah, but it's really expensive, it's well known, it must be good. Quite often it's not.
Mm. So what's your advice for somebody who's picking, if you like, a therapist, a beauty therapist, to help them move things forward? You know, how do you go about doing that? Because for me, you know, what you've just said about products is about picking somebody who has a wide knowledge of products and not somebody who's wedded to a particular product.
You need to read reviews and talk to people. Go along and meet a therapist first, or just go for a basic facial. I always offer like a free facial if someone's unsure, give a lot away in raffles and stuff, so people can come and see me. And just talk to them.
Mm.
You can't just go along and expect to have a relationship with someone straight away. You need to talk to them and just, you know.
But I would also want them to have that, to have the ability to switch products, you know, because if my skin changes, you know, so I'm using their product and then suddenly something happens, perhaps I go through menopause or I'm taking some other sort of medication, and my skin becomes dry and my skin becomes greasy. I'd want them to be able to say, oh, okay, actually, this range may be better for you. Not, I only work, you know, this is who I'm wedded to. I sell them, they sponsor me or they whatever.
Definitely, because again, I messaged Fiona in between. I said, Fiona, my skin's all really dry all of a sudden. And she said, don't worry then. She went on to the... I can switch it up and bring this in. She didn't say, oh, I'm really sorry, I'm only stuck with that brand. Yeah. And then, because we'd communicated, when I got there, she went, right, I've changed it, we're going to do this. And we tried something else and it's worked. So, I would definitely have a therapist that's not welded to one brand, because then you can have a communicate. And that's what we do. Or I turn up and she goes to me, what's happened to your face? Right, I'm doing this.
I'll put everything away.
Yeah, she puts everything away and got another one out, because she said to me, oh, you look a bit tired.
Not doing that today.
But again, that's because we've built a relationship up. And that's the same with like the woman who does my full body massage. I've got a relationship with her, and I go, well, actually, Adelle, your shoulders, I'm going to work more on that.
Yeah.
Because it's that consistency. Then that way, you've got people looking after you. Yeah. And for me, as a busy woman in business, delegate it. I've delegated my face to Fiona, so it's her fault.
But you have to be open with your therapist as
well.
Honest. You have to say, if you've got a problem. There's nothing worse than hearing someone say, oh, yeah, but I went to see Fiona, she did my face, and I've got this dry patch still, and it's not any good, and I've got this dark patch. If you've not told me about it and it's bothering you,
I'm not going to work on that area. So you need to be honest and open and upfront about what you're looking for, what your goals are with your visit.
And I also think it's nice, you know, when I go and see somebody, I'm also supporting them in the business community.
Absolutely.
It's not just about, hey, I'm going out and I'm treating myself and somebody's going to be waiting on me. It's not, you know, we're women collaboration. It's women in business. Mm. And I think we're going to have to leave it on that note, because I want to make sure that we get some contact details in. Very quickly, Adelle. What else should we be doing, perhaps exercise-wise? Mm. So people are listening in. They may not have time. They may not have money. Mm. We've slapped some stuff on our face. We've played around with some fruit. Mm. What is it? What can you do to sort of also keep things going?
One thing I say to my busy business women, get outside and get some steps in.
Outside.
Yeah, sorry. You've got to get outside into that vitamin D, that fresh air, and do some walk and try and include somewhere with a hill or some steps. So you can build up.
So just build in some regular walking. I tell you what, we hear that so often, don't we? But we don't damn well do it. I don't anyway. I hear it, but I don't do it. Great. You know, I get to the end of the day and what's happened? I've been sat in front of the computer doing stuff for hours and hours and hours on end. Mm. So it's a case of getting something diarised, isn't it?
Put it in the diary. Yeah,
getting it definitely. In the diary and getting it out there. And I tell you what, I don't forget to do my face, because I get really uncomfortable if I do. Mm. So perhaps we need to look at it in that way. I'm not going to forget to go doing my walk, because it leads on to things that I think sometimes we just accept. We get used to having a pain in our hip, or we get used to our back hurting. In actual fact, if we got up and walked around, we may find that we didn't have that.
No. And the one I get is about hip pain. I said, because you've shortened your hip flexors by sitting down all day. So get up, go for a walk, and try and put some steps or a heel in.
Mm.
That's what I'd say.
Well, I think we've put it all right to rights now, don't we? I think we're looking good. We're feeling good. I tell you what, I quite like this. It'll be really interesting to hear what our listeners think about our new format and for focusing on ourselves. Okay, thank you so much, folks. Fiona, how can people get hold of you?
On Instagram, Microblading and More by Fiona, and same on Facebook as well, and microbladingandmore.co.uk.
Brilliant. We will see you all again soon with the Women in Business Radio Show, where we start off with business startups, business growth, and then we go on to the second half of our show.
Look
good, feel good. Right, well, I'll tell you what, it's nearly 1 o'clock. So, yes, we're going to go outside and we're going to walk to the wine bar. Okay. We'll see you all soon. Bye.
Week to the Women in Business Radio Show for more stories, ideas, and inspiration to help you grow your business.